Called the Sir Winston Churchill, and it's part of an organization called the Sail Training Association. So I'm going to ask the man in charge, Captain Adrian Allenby, to tell us all about the ship and its special crew.
Welcome aboard, Dana, and how very nice to see you on board our ship, Sir Winston Churchill, this afternoon.
Thank you very much.
And as a little presentation for having made such a monumental climb up the ship's side, can you we present you with a little badge of our ship, which I'll try and pin on your jacket there.
Oh, that's lovely. Thank you.
Take away as a souvenir of the ship.
Oh,
there we are.
Oh, that's
gone successfully in.
Thank you very much indeed.
Not at all. Delightful to have you on board this afternoon.
Thanks. You've got a very special crew on board, haven't you? Tell us about what they're going to do.
Well, they are special. Yes, they only joined the ship yesterday afternoon, and they've come to see you for the first time this afternoon. And they're here for a very special voyage, in fact. They're spending half the week on board, of half their time on board the ship here. We'll be sailing around in the Firth of Clyde and a little bit further beyond. And then next week, they'll be going and climbing on the Isle of Arran across the way there and doing some camping and mountaineering as part of their Duke of Edinburgh Award certificate. So
well,
it is indeed a special crew.
Presumably, they're not sunbathing the whole time they're on board here. What are they going to
do? They'd like to think they're sunbathing, but no, they won't indeed. And we've put out some sails this afternoon, and they'll be putting up some more, obviously, during the course of the time, and sailing the ship around. And we'll be putting the ship through her paces. We'll be getting instruction as well, and generally working and sailing the ship.
They actively sail the ship, they?
Yes, they are very much the crew. They have to do everything on board the ship, whether it be steering the ship, putting up sails, cleaning the loos out, keeping watches at night. They are the crew and do everything.
And does it really have an effect on them, I mean, on their lives? Does it change in this experience?
I think it does give them a lot of confidence in their lives. A lot of them come here and they realise when they leave in 2 weeks' time that they've achieved a lot of things which they didn't think they could do when they first arrived here. It's one thing to stay up to 4 o'clock in the morning when you're going to a disco with a girlfriend, but it's another thing to stay up to 4 o'clock in the morning when you're on a cold, wet deck where the rain's pouring down and the sea is coming over the bars. And you're